I'm the Central Library Manager at the Central Library in downtown Portland. I've administered naloxone once.
The most recent time I was having a smoke break right in front of my work, actually. And the individual was just across the street.
He was breathing very shallowly. He was not responding. He was unconscious, in and out of consciousness.
I remember I was texting my friend, man, there's nothing going on at work today. And then about 1 minute later, I heard somebody across the street yelling, Narcan, Narcan. And so I went and ran and got the Narcan. And then I ran back across the street and they were still going, Narcan, Narcan. And I said, Narcan?
You know, I was feeling a little hesitant. I had never used naloxone before, but had seen my colleagues use it, and they had all said the same thing. Don't hesitate, just go ahead and administer it. You can't do any harm.
Like, to me, the hardest is the moments just before taking action, and once I'm already underway, it's easier to convince myself to follow through. It's easier to, like, drown out that internal voice of doubt.
We administered the naloxone and waited for the cavalry to arrive, while at the same time trying to keep him awake and talking to us.
You will never know when it might happen, and there is probably nothing more important than potentially saving a life.
Here are signs and symptoms to look out for to identify an overdose. The person is unresponsive or unconscious, and their body is limp. They have slow, shallow, or no breathing. They're making snoring, gurgling, or choking sounds. Their fingernails or lips are turning blue or gray.
If you think someone is experiencing an opioid overdose, check to see if they're breathing. Look for their chest, rising and falling. Put your ear near the person's face to listen and feel for breaths. Try to wake the person up by shouting and tapping them on the chest. If they don't respond, call 911 immediately and say, "Someone isn't breathing. I think they may have overdosed on opioids and I have naloxone."
Support the person's breathing with rescue breathing and chest compressions. If you're willing and trained, provide rescue breathing for 2 breaths. Clear the airway, make sure it's not blocked. Place 1 hand on the person's chin, tilt the head back, and pinch the nose closed. Use a face mask or place your hand around the person's mouth to make a seal and give 2 slow breaths. The person's chest should rise, but not the stomach. Do chest compressions for 2 minutes. Place heel of 1 hand over center of person's chest. Place other hand on top of first hand, keeping elbows straight with shoulders directly above hands. Use body weight to push straight down at least 2 inches at rate of 100 compressions per minute. If they still don't respond, administer naloxone. Naloxone only works on people who have overdosed on opioids, so there is no danger in administering it to someone who hasn't overdosed.
To be safe, if a person's appearance matches the signs and symptoms of an overdose, it's best to administer naloxone and wait until emergency responders arrive. If your naloxone kit contains a syringe set up to be given as a nasal spray, here's how it works. Pull or pry off both top and bottom covers on the syringe. Screw the white cone onto the top of the barrel of the syringe. Pry off the cap of the naloxone capsule. Screw the naloxone cartridge into the barrel of the syringe. Grip the clear plastic wings. Insert the white cone into the nostril. Give a short, vigorous push on the end of the naloxone cartridge to spray naloxone into the nose. 1/2 of the cartridge goes into each nostril. Continue rescue breathing and chest compressions, as it may take several minutes for the naloxone to come into effect. If the person does not respond within 2 to 3 minutes, administer a second dose. Additional doses may be given every 2 to 3 minutes until the person responds or emergency help arrives.
Stay with the person to monitor their response until emergency medical services arrive. Roll the person over slightly onto their side. Put the person's top hand under the person's head to support it. Bend the top knee. This position should keep the person from rolling onto their stomach or back so the person does not choke if they vomit. If they wake up, keep them calm and tell them what's happened. They'll probably be disoriented, upset, and feel very ill from opioid withdrawal.
Signs of opioid withdrawal include body aches and fever, irritability and restlessness, vomiting and diarrhea, shivering and sweating. These symptoms are uncomfortable but not life-threatening. The person should be monitored until emergency first responders arrive, or at least 2 hours after the last dose of naloxone. Again, these are the steps to take to reverse overdose. Look. Check. Call. Breathe. Spray. Stay. Oregon has a law that protects anyone who administers naloxone in a good faith effort to reverse an opioid overdose.
The opioid crisis is not, it's just picking up more steam as time goes on, it seems. And, you know, the best thing we can do to look out for one another is to make sure we are preventing death that we have the resources and technology and knowledge to prevent.
Yeah, it was intense. All of these situations that I've observed also have been pretty intense. But what I've appreciated is that everybody comes together and there are, you know, 30 different things that need to happen all at exactly the same time, and people being willing to help and do that teamwork and just respond to help another human being. It's really powerful.
It's always worth it to save a life.